Hi, my name is Ryan J. Salva, and I'm one of the many program managers responsible for delivering Visual Studio 2015. Today, I want to share some of the new features available in this release, features introduced specifically to help developers like you build mobile apps for iOS, Android, and Windows using web technologies. Now, if you're not already familiar with Apache Cordova, it's an open source framework that enables developers to build packaged apps for mobile devices using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And unlike web apps, packaged apps give you access to native device capabilities like the camera or file system, support for offline scenarios, and the opportunity for monetization in the app stores. They also solve an important discoverability problem as more and more consumers choose to engage with apps on their mobile devices rather than the browser. Now, since we first announced Visual Studio support for Apache Cordova at TechEd in June, thousands of developers have used these tools to build packaged apps for iOS, Android, and Windows. And today I'm excited to announce we're releasing an update to the extension for Visual Studio 2013 and incorporating the same features into the Visual Studio 2015 release. No matter which version of the tools you install, as an extension to Visual Studio 2013 or included with Visual Studio 2015, the developer experience will be nearly identical, starting with installation. If you've ever done cross-platform development, you know that compilation for each platform requires a litany of open source and platform-specific components. Building for Android requires Ant, Java, and the Android SDK. Deploying to an iOS device requires iTunes, and Windows requires the Windows SDK. After all is said and done, there are over a dozen toolchain dependencies that can take hours, even days, to properly download, install, and configure. Much more, some of these components update out of your control and require continued maintenance, days of your life that could be spent solving real problems with code. Visual Studio will get you up and running quickly with a well-configured dev environment and help you stay that way. When you install our tools or open a Cordova project, Visual Studio performs an environmental diagnostic. If you're missing any dependencies or have somehow misconfigured an important link in the toolchain, Visual Studio will give you the option to fix the problem. Missing software? VS will download and install it. Misconfigured? VS will help you fix it. Once you're up and running, most of your time will be spent between the code editor and an emulator or a tethered device. To write code quickly and with fewer mistakes, developers have long relied on Visual Studio's IntelliSense for contextual help. Cordova's no different. Whether you're using JavaScript or TypeScript, you can depend on first-rate IntelliSense to guide you along the way. Let's take it on a spin. So, I've got a new blank Cordova project open here, and I want to build an application that takes advantage of the camera. This isn't something you could do with a normal web application, at least not without a tangle of browser-specific code. And Cordova abstracts away all the device-specific implementation into something called a Cordova plugin. Plugins provide a nice, normalized JavaScript API so I can reliably access the camera across iOS, Android, and Windows using one syntax. I'm going to start by going to the config designer, which has been totally redesigned in this release, where I can find a list of core plugins vetted by Microsoft for compatibility with the most common in-market devices. Knowing that Microsoft has tested these plugins for compatibility is a huge confidence booster. And here, I find one for the camera. We're going to go ahead and add that guy in. Visual Studio tells me the version, the description, the platforms that it's compatible with. And if you look over here in the Solution Explorer, you'll see that Visual Studio has actually acquired the plugin and copied it locally to my project. All right, now that we've acquired the plugin, let's use it. Plugins like the camera use an asynchronous call to request data from the mobile device. I have some boilerplate code here that I'm going to copy and paste. Just apply to all. Excellent. And here, if we go into index.js, we'll see where some of that new code got added. Here, within the function where we invoke the plugin, you'll see navigator.camera.getPicture. That's the plugin itself. I'm going to invoke a similar method just by typing here, and you'll see that IntelliSense comes right up. .camera, there we go, .getPicture. As I move my mouse over that, I get an explanation of the method, its parameters, and how it can be used. If I'm using a popular framework, for example, Angular or Bootstrap, I get similar IntelliSense for both JavaScript and HTML. Let's see how it works in iOS. For that, I'm going to deploy to the iOS simulator running on a Mac in my local network. As you can see, it's just come to the forefront, and here we are, here's my application. Back in Visual Studio, the debugger is hooked up to the iOS simulator. The same would be true for a tethered iOS device, Android emulator, Windows Phone, whatever. No matter where I've deployed my app, I can use the same debugging tools to set breakpoints, inspect the DOM, and send commands via the console. To better understand how this works, I'm going to set a breakpoint. In fact, we'll do that right on the method where we invoke the camera plugin. And when I invoke that function by clicking on the Photo Library button, I can inspect the variable at my breakpoint and see exactly what value I've got in each of my variables and methods. Awesome. Of course, updates to Visual Studio don't tell the whole story. It's also about giving back. Through our partnership with the Apache Cordova community, we've contributed several updates to the framework in the last few months, including support for Windows 8.1 universal projects, platform-specific configuration settings, and security updates benefiting all target platforms. We're working with an industry-wide community of contributors to ensure Apache Cordova is enterprise-ready. So, that's about it for now. We covered only a fraction of the new features available for building multi-device apps with Apache Cordova, but you can already see that there's tremendous potential for developers, especially web developers, who want to adapt their HTML and JavaScript skills to mobile app development. Compared to native application development, where you would have to develop the same app three times, once in Objective-C for iOS, then again in Java for Android, and again in C# for Windows, Cordova allows you to develop quickly and iteratively using well-understood web technologies. We hope you'll give it a try and send your feedback. You can find the product team on Twitter at @VSCordovaTools and download the product on visualstudio.com. Until next time, I'm Ryan J. Salvo with Visual Studio Tools for Apache Cordova. Happy coding, everyone.